football. In the ring from Raleigh, North Carolina, weighing in at 195 pounds, Shannon.
This past week on SmackDown, Shannon Moore suffered a tremendous twist of fate as he was overhead belly to suplex over the top rope by Brock Lesnar and an F10 by Brock Lesnar.
And from El Paso, Texas, weighing in at 213 pounds, one half of the WWE Tag Team Champions, Chavo.
With Ernest the Cat.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas! You know, kid, I love Christmas, I love Velocity, and I love my mama.
Hey, speaking of your mama, did you hear that Santa Claus was kissing her?
You won't see a cat shove a Christmas tree up a kid ass. Keep my mom out of there.
All set for exciting cruiserweight action right here on Velocity. But Cat, we just saw Brock Lesnar is on a tear, and Brock Lesnar has got to be furious. We saw the action spike Kurt Angle this past week on SmackDown. Kurt Angle is the new champion, but like we said, he has a new agent in Paul Heyman. And that can't make Brock Lesnar happy at all.
You know, Paul is like Don King, you know? He got a piece of everybody.
Well, Paul Heyman makes sure that he is in a win-win situation every week. We've got exciting cruiserweight action right here on Velocity. Shannon Moore taking on Chavo Guerrero. And you got to wonder how Shannon Moore is even in the ring right now after suffering that overhead belly-to-belly suplex from Brock Lesnar out of the ring.
Over my ass, he got his ass beat, man.
He definitely did, but Shannon Moore, he's a tough kid. He's in the ring right now with Chavo Guerrero. And what a role Chavo's been on as of late. One half of the WWE Tag Team Champions with his Uncle Eddie Guerrero.
Uncle Eddie is what I call him.
Uncle Eddie. Uncle Eddie. Oh. Nice forearm to the back by Chavo Guerrero.
Get him out.
And Pat, we understand that after SmackDown went off the air this past week, there was a huge, huge incident between Brock Lesnar and Kurt Angle.
Man, that was just incredible, man, the action.
Yeah, well, we don't know now. Whoa, look at that. Nice deep arm drag there by Shannon Moore. And a huge spin heel kick there.
Man, that Shannon Moore is tough.
Cover there by Shannon, a kick out there by Chavo.
Tough kid.
Chavo's pretty tough, too, kicking out after a one count. Chavo hard in the book. Nice kick there by Shannon Moore. Cover again, and a kick up by Chavo. Quick cruiserweight action that you only see on SmackDown and Velocity. So now, Cat, we don't know the fate of next week's main event right here on SmackDown.
Oh, come on,
Chavo. Chavo giving up.
Yeah,
I don't know what.
Chavo catches Shannon Moore, and Chavo, being the technician that he is, knows where Shannon Moore is hurting right there in the lower back and takes advantage of it. And, Cat, now we don't know the fate of the main event of SmackDown next week. Will it be the Big Show versus Kurt Angle? After what transpired after SmackDown went off the air last week between Brock Lesnar and Kurt Angle.
I heard about it back in the back. I heard all the action going on. I just couldn't get out there. Well, somebody got hurt bad, I think.
Somebody better call your mama.
Yeah, she already know I called her last night.
Cover there by Chavo and a kick out. I called her last night, too.
Watch it, mama. You know, I used to work with Chavo back at WCW days. You know, he was a nice guy back then. Look at him, he's vicious now.
Yeah, he's one half of the tag team champions here in the WWE.
I think he's getting this from his uncle. Uncle Ed is teaching this kid how to be vicious. That's the only way to get anywhere in this business. Uncle Eddie, I tell you, they stumped a mud hole in his ass last week. I haven't seen a good mud hole stumping like that in a long time, kid.
Well, that mud hole stomping caused Chris Benoit to come down and help out Billy Kidman from that two-on-one
situation. He had no business there, man. You know, all the way back to WCW, Chris Benoit always sticking his nose.
Roll up by Shannon Moore here. Schoolboy, and a kick out there by Eddie Guerrero.
If Shannon Moore don't watch it, they'll be stuffing the mud hole in his ass, too.
How can you say that Chris Benoit had no business helping out Billy Kidman, the cruiserweight champion? Last week, he was getting beat down by Los Guerrero.
He's not Billy Kidman's uncle.
All right.
I know you don't understand that, kid. Family, we stick together.
Whatever you saw.
Oh, man.
Big side salto kick there.
I got to give it a
Shannon Moore.
He's tough.
Absolutely.
He's not a quitter like you, kid.
Well, after the beating he took from Brock Lesnar last week, you couldn't blame Shannon Moore if he wasn't out here this week, but he's out here fighting. And now, Neck breaker there by Shannon Moore. Cover. This could do it. Got a kick out there by Eddie Guerrero.
And Shannon Moore, he has a lot of heart.
Absolutely. And Kat, you have to figure that the winner of this match should be in the running for a shot at the Cruiserweight Championship.
Oh.
Shannon Moore up and over, taking Chavo down, and now Shannon Moore is going up to the stratosphere. And look at that, the high flying Shannon Moore. Cover. And Chavo just gets the shoulder up. Kat, what does Shannon Moore have to do to put Chavo Guerrero away? You don't know, do you?
Of course not. That's why I'm watching the match just like you. Oh, look at that. You can't pull him away.
And now, Chavo. The gory bomb, and now cover there by Chavo. And that's going to do it.
And that's what Josh, he did without Eddie. Uncle Eddie didn't have to come down.
Guerrero.
I like that top Chavo, man. I love it.
Chavo Guerrero has been on a roll, and now Chavo is aligning himself to be the number one contender for the Cruiserweight title.
You know, I love that music. You hear that music? I love it.
What do you call those? Macarenas or something? Like that? You don't want to talk about that. The 10th anniversary special of Raw coming in January. Make sure you get your vote in at WWE.com.
Contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, weighing in at 350 pounds, Rikishi. And in the ring, weighing in at 225 pounds, Andy Anderson.
WWE Velocity is brought to you by JVC's Tower of Power with 460 watts of mind-numbing sound, dual 8-inch subs, and MP3 playback. The Tower of Power by JVC. And by the new Castrol GTX High Mileage. And by Starburst Fruit Chews. Is it life juicy?
Oh, yeah. Speaking of juicy, what about that Dawn and Tori?
Yeah. Dawn came through on her promise and showed everyone what happened in room 357 last week at Armageddon.
Man, I tell you, those two beautiful girls in there just kissing on each other, hugging each other, getting me all hot and steamy out here. Especially looking at all this ass in the ring.
All that ass in the ring with Kishi and Andy Anderson right now.
Andy Anderson?
Yeah, he's got the tights.
Was he on Mayberry? Huh? Was Andy on?
Kat, that was Andy Griffith, not Andy Anderson.
See, man, you look like Barney Fife, so I, you know, anyway, I don't watch that show. Let's watch this right here. Let's go. Put your eyes on it. Put your eyes on it, Rikishi. Yeah.
And anyway, you know, speaking of, I don't even know what you're talking about, but how about Tori Wilson? How does she have to feel right now after seeing that footage?
I don't give a damn. I want a copy of that tape, man. He just got slapped. I can't believe that, man.
I'm going to slap him.
Oh, that's a payback as hell. Look at him.
Rikishi. What a slam there by Rikishi.
Oh, man, Rikishi, I tell you, he's quick, man, for a big man.
And you know who else is pretty quick? Is Al Wilson. And in 2 weeks on SmackDown, Al Wilson is going to marry Dawn Marie.
Man, quick, he's an ass, man. You know that little idiot, man. I tell you, what can he do with that young girl? And she can have a big stunt like the Cat.
Yeah, I bet you wish you were in Al Wilson's shoes right now. He can marry her.
I wouldn't tell you what, my feet are too big for this kid, that guy, man.
He wears
You can't call him a kid. He's 110. Oh, what a beautiful
Well, if you're gonna wrestle with Rikishi, that's the way to take him out, is to get him where it hurts, right in the knees there. I bet you got some pointers for Al Wilson on his honeymoon.
Bro, I'm not gonna tell you, kid. You some kind of pervert, man. You keep. Why? Come on, I tell you what, kid. We'll wait and get that copy of the tape.
Give it up. Rikishi right now feeling the effects of Andy Anderson. But how about Rikishi and John Cena? John Cena and B2 have really been playing with the mind of Rikishi as of late.
And those two guys are crazy playing with something. That, man, this size, man.
Well, 2 weeks ago on SmackDown, John Cena used his jewelry as a weapon, hitting Rikishi over the head with that chain he wears around his neck. John Cena and B2 are playing with fire right now. I just got to ask you right now.
Oh.
What exactly is bling bling, and what is that thing that B2 wears around his head?
Oh,
small drop by Rikishi.
Kid, you know, kid, I need to take you back to the hood with me, man. Bling bling is the diamonds, the gold, the everything. Oh, look at all that junk in that trunk. Put it on him. Oh, oh man, I wonder who taught him that sidekick, man. That's a beautiful kick. You know, I'm a three-time world karate champion.
I know you are, now, Pat. You tell me all the time.
I could do everything, but I can't back that ass up.
Oh! Crookshaker by Rikishi.
Oh, he put that ass on him. Yeah, yeah. I wonder if he can still dance. Can he still dance? Yell out there, tell him to dance. Yell at him, kid.
Hey, Rikishi, please dance for the cat so he can shut the hell up.
Get him out of there. Yeah, open the floor up.
Rikishi all taking care of Andy Anderson right here on Velocity.
And up next, Build Him Up might not be vying for the WWE Championship, but this guy definitely is a contender.
Let's see if Jonah can really hack it or not. For all of you Tough Enough fans out there, Tough Enough 3 will be preempted due to the holidays. So be sure to tune back in January 2nd to find out who's going to last. For 2 weeks left.
One ball, making it 20 lane, weighing in at 280 pounds, Bill DeMott.
I tell you what, Josh, you was on that Tough Enough, right?
Uh-huh.
You know, how would your trainer compare to this guy, man? This guy right here is just crazy.
Yeah, I'm very thankful that Bill DeMott was not a trainer when I was on. He's demented. He's 280-pound bully with a bad attitude and a very big chip on his shoulder. And Michael Shane is going to feel the effects of Bill DeMott right here.
Oh.
You know Bill DeMott. You guys were in WCW together.
He wasn't like this, though, man. You guys up here in WWE did something to this man to make him like this now. Look at him.
Yeah, somebody brought this side out of Bill DeMott. Choking Michael Shane out right now. You know, last week on SmackDown, Cat, Bill DeMott was in tag team action with Crash Holly taking on Jamie Noble and his cousin Nunzio.
Tag team match, kid. What kind of tag team match was that? He beat the hell out of everybody in the ring.
Well, that was the point I was getting to. Bill DeMott was on his own in that one. Took out Nunzio and Jamie Noble, and then took out Crash. Oh, and now he's going to take out Michael Shane.
Oh, man. I tell you what, man, you think I can get a tape of that Torrey Wilson, that done? You know, I need a copy of that tape.
Okay, I know.
Come on, kid, help me out, you pervert.
I know you're really excited about seeing that. Oh! But you gotta feel for Torrey Wilson.
I don't feel for nobody but me because I need a tape.
Build him out.
Come on. Come on, Josh, you call the 900 number. Won't you get me a tape?
I just feel bad for Torrey Wilson and the fact that Al Wilson and Don Rickard.
You just feel yourself.
Oh.
I want to take.
What a powerbomb.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
What a powerbomb there by Bill DeMott.
You feel bad. I tell you what, just feel for me. Get the kind of copy of that tape in room 357.
And now Bill DeMott is headed to the top rope. And now Bill DeMott. Oh, that's a 280-pound moonsault.
Drag him out of there. It's a 187.
Here's your winner, Bill DeMott.
280.
A 187, baby.
He weighs 280 pounds.
A 187 is what we call in the hood when you take out a man.
187?
187.
Let's take a look at this moonsault again by Bill DeMott.
Oh.
All over Michael Shane. Bill DeMott is a very disturbed man. As you just saw, Jamie Noble promised that he'd bring in his cousin Nunzio, and he did just that. Nunzio debuted 2 weeks ago and brutally attacked Crash Holly.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Approaching ring, being accompanied by his girlfriend Nidia from Hanover, West Virginia, weighing in at 200 pounds, Jamie Noble.
I bet you can teach Nidia a thing or two. And PlayStation 2 presents WWE Royal Rumble. Living your world, playing ours. The Royal Rumble comes to you live January 19th from the Fleet Center in Boston, Mass. Cat, you can get your tickets. ticket. They're on sale right now.
I don't need a ticket, kid. What are you talking about?
Funaki.
Funaki and Jamie Noble all set for action right here. And Ted, I know you have your eyes on Nidia.
Have my eyes on that. I wonder who in the hell dresses her, man. I mean, you know, a good old girl like that, I can take her back home with me and dress up, put a little lipstick on her, and she can make me my money.
You would take Nidia to Hotland? I don't think she know what to do.
See, I'll lead her. I'll guide her. I'll be her advisor, okay? Oh, Funaki is getting knocky.
Jamie Noble stopping Funaki right now.
Get up, boy!
Oh, hey, kid. Did you see me do my big interview with Edge on SmackDown?
I did. It was awesome.
Oh, man. Oh!
That drop there by Funaki. Nice step over toehold there. And now Funaki.
Oh, Funaki. I love that name, Funaki.
Cover there by Funaki after the drop kick to the forehead. And a kick out by Jamie, by God Noble.
By God Noble, yeah.
And Kat, we know now that we will see the footage this week on SmackDown of what went down when SmackDown went off the air this past week between Kurt Angle and Brock Lesnar. We know it was huge. Oh! And Noble hanging Funaki up right there on the top rope.
Is this going to still be Kurt Angle against the Big Show?
Well, hopefully we'll find out the answer to that question this week on SmackDown. We know that whatever happened has affected the main event for this week on SmackDown, covered by Jamie Noble, and a kick out by Funaki.
You know, I love that Funogi.
It's Funaki.
Is that some kind of French name or something?
Oh, he's Japanese.
Oh, okay. Yeah, come on, Funaki!
Funaki counters that and a kick out there by Jamie Noble. But whatever happens, if it is the Big Show versus Kurt Angle this week on SmackDown, Paul Heyman is in a win-win situation, because he's the agent of both the Big Show and Kurt Angle.
That's good. Ain't nobody telling him to sign the contract.
And now Jamie Noble going for a head and arm suplex there, but Funaki counters. And now Funaki with the enziguri. Covered by Funaki, and a kick out by Noble.
So, kid, what do you think about Paul Heyman being the agent for both guys?
Well, Paul Heyman has positioned himself in the perfect way. He's got nothing to worry about this week on SmackDown.
I know, man. That's Don King movement right there. You know, I wanted to be signed that Don King contract.
What a power slam and a kick out by Funaki.
And, kid, I got another question for you. What do you think about me and Nidia together?
What do you think about Kurt Angle and his integrity speech?
You didn't answer my question, kid.
And Funaki now slingshots Jamie Noble into the turnbuckle.
Kid, are you deaf? Are you ignoring me?
Oh, and a bulldog by Funaki. Cover by Funaki. And, a kick out there by Jamie Noble.
Kid,
and Nidia is very happy about that.
Can you hear me talking to you?
Backslap. What's that?
Do you hear me talking to you?
Yeah. What a close line by Funaki.
Don't look at Nidia. Leave her for me.
Nidia has a lot of integrity. Kurt Angle has zero integrity.
That's what I like about Nidia. Cheap. Cheap date. You don't have to spend no money on clothes.
Right hands and chops by Funaki. Jamie Noble, and now Funaki. Going for a tornado DDT, and chops by Jamie Noble.
Oh, man. You know, Jamie was with me.
Funaki fires back in now.
That's a bitch slap.
Funaki going for a tornado DDT. Noble comes again. Noble ducks the close
Jamie.
And a neck breaker by Jamie Noble.
I tell you, look at it.
Noble now going for the Tiger Bomb. And, there it is. Funaki all stacked up, and Jamie Noble defeats Funaki.
Look at all that.
Here is your winner, Jamie Noble.
You know, I like when Noble wins because Nidia jumps around. Look at that.
Well, this Thursday night on SmackDown, we will show you the footage of what went down when SmackDown went off the air last week between Brock Lesnar and Kurt Angle. And, there's Cousin Nidia. Nidia wants to congratulate Jamie Noble, but hey, Cat Confidential is right now.